of questions inside. Got a whole world of fine. There's a lot to discover. James got your bridges to build, your dreams to fulfill. It's all there waiting for you to find. And your friends, they'll all stand behind you. And if you forget, you know they'll remind you. James, like a river that flows, there's so much to know. There's so much out there for you. James, you got it all in your hands. It's your life and it's all up to you, James.
Walter Haskell of Jefferson High took the lead and is stroking hard. Our noble Don in Black is driving like mad to close the gap. Third is Brother Clinton, and moving up fast in lane number six is James Hunter. Needless to say, all these fine athletes know it's a stick and they're swimming like it too. It all comes down to this. Bunker Hill High has 82 points and Jefferson High has 79. The winner of this final event goes, say hey, all the way to Oakville, Massachusetts for the state finals. Yes, it all comes down to that. Okay, they're approaching the turn, and Walter Haskell still has the lead by a Nance Eyebrown. Here they go. They're into it, and Don Black takes the lead. It was Clinton and Hunter showing power. Uh-oh, Haskell isn't giving up that easy, and he's driving like mad. But Don Black has found the power, and he's just driving and pulling away. Here comes Haskell, they're in the stretch, and Don Black pulls away from Haskell. Here comes Clinton, Clinton passes Haskell, and Haskell just must have burned himself out with that quick start, because Hunter is neck and neck with Clinton. Here they come, and what do you know? Bunker Hill's taking it, 1, 2, 3!
One of the great moments in radio lost forever.
Coach Pedersen says, when the going gets tough, the tough get going, right?
Okay, well, the thing is, we won, huh?
Right, we won!
Hey, we won! Hey, hey!
Come on, you guys, throw that dust to the towels.
Oh, bug off, Schwartz.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah!
This is Sly Eggleton coming to you from the winning locker room of the Bunker Hill High Swim Team, where they've just qualified for the state finals. We play a heroic effort of one Duke Tanny. Let's see if we can get a word from our third place finisher. Excuse me, James, how do you feel?
Fine. a little tired, but happy.
And happy you should be. You know, I noticed you really turned it on at the end. Were you pacing yourself?
No. I just knew that if we didn't win, we wouldn't get to the finals. So I guess it was like that extra shot of adrenaline, you know?
Yeah, man, the way you finished at the end, they should give you a saliva test. Hey, Duke, did you think you were going to win that last race?
Yeah, I felt pretty confident. After all, you don't get to be captain of the swim team for nothing, you know.
You're too modest, Duke. Are you excited about going to Oakville for the finals?
Well, when you've been in as many big ones as I have, it's a little hard to get keyed up. But don't worry. When that gun goes off, I'll be there.
Thank you. Duke Channing. Now let's see who else we can talk to.
Hey! Take it down. Now, I want to say that I'm proud of each and every one of you. Now, the way you swam out there today would make fish jealous. As you all know, next week we go up to Oakville for the final. Now, I'm sorry to say we won't be able to take everybody up to Oakville. We just don't have the funds. But the ones that don't get to go, don't feel bad. You can be there in spirit. Now, that's what life's all about. All right.
My trick is I spin by the towel. That's what makes him so soft and nice. I figure if you're going to be an equipment manager, be the best. You know, I've never had one pair of swimming trunks fade.
Well, thank you very much, Wirtz.
Although back in 77 once, I can remember a good time.
This is Sly Hazeltine signing off, saying, if you can't play a sport, be a sport.
It's neck and neck with Clinton. Here they come. And what do you know? Bobby.
Hey.
Technical
difficulties, bro.
Hey, Sly, see what you can do with this.
Well, all right. Schwartz picks up the pizza. He's poising it at his mouth.
He's wrapping a stringy bit of cheese around his tongue, and yeah, he looks like he's gonna go all the way.
Go, Schwartz!
Can he do it?
And he doesn't make it!
Next time, Schwartz. Let's try.
You know, it's too bad you can't make it to the finals with us, man, because it's really gonna kick.
Well, if Coach Pedersen isn't gonna take all the dudes on the team, I doubt if he'd be hip to taking a silver-throated devil like myself.
There must be some way to convince the coach into taking you along.
No way. If I'm not going to take Guy from the team, I'm certainly not going to take a radio announcer. Besides, if I let you go, I'd have to let everyone else go.
Well, who else wants to go?
Well, that tall, goofy kid from the yearbook, Ramona Hopkins from the student council.
Well, listen, Coach, you know Sly did coverage for the football and the basketball team, and the basketball coach gave a pretty good interview. It's just we feel you're a lot more interesting than he is.
You're right in the money there.
And I think it'd be a great idea to let the whole school see what a fantastic swimming coach we have.
Yeah, that's right.
Well.
Hey, pass it around.
I'm entering the bus now, and you can cut the tension with a knife. I'm really glad to be here with
all these enthusiastic
swimmers.
They're just towels.
Towels? This is my lunch.
Hold it. You guys want to keep it down a bit? I'm trying to think about swimming.
It's like last year, huh, dude?
Don't worry. That won't happen again.
Why? What happened last year?
Oh, you wouldn't believe it if I told you.
What?
Okay, you guys. Come on, knock it off.
Teeling.
I want you to remember, you're all students of Bunker Hill High, and you're representing your school. I want you to conduct yourselves in an orderly fashion. Now, this means no drinking, no smoking of any kind, no entertaining members of the opposite sex.
Sure.
This won't be like last year. Lights out at 10 o'clock, and I personally will conduct bed checks.
Heil Hitler.
All right. Now, remember, clean mind, clean body.
Take your choice.
And one more thing, and win. One second, I gotta call head of the motel.
Hey, guys, what was that they were saying about last year?
Well, you heard of the famous Saturday Night Massacre, haven't you?
Yeah, last year in Pittsville.
I wasn't here last year, remember?
Well, you know who Wild Bill Kratzky is, don't you?
Well, yeah, he was the captain of the team last year, wasn't he?
Yeah. We were in Pittsville 20 minutes, and Kratzky had five girls set up for a party that night.
Well, how'd he get him by fetters?
He had him dress up like maids. Pedersen thought he were doing our room.
And oh, did they do our room.
Hey, no lie.
I wish old Kransky was here with us now. He knows how to make things happen.
Well, what was so special about Kransky?
That indefinable something. Who knows? But whatever it was, he had it.
Yeah? Well, if you guys think because Kransky is in here, we're not going to have any fun, you got another thing coming.
Hey, Hunter, Kransky has some pretty big feet. You don't think he can fill his shoes, do you?
Well...
Oh, this is gonna kick. No parents, no teachers, and a motel.
M-O-T-E-L. Yabba dabba doo.
Oh, yeah. Well. My first motel. It's just like I pictured it in my wildest dreams.
I can't stand it. Color TV in every room. Hot and cold chambermaid.
Yeah, I'll run away from you, Schwartz.
Yeah, I'm starving, man. Those bus rides really get my appetite going. Hey, Coach, when do we eat?
All right, you guys. Now, hold up. Now, listen up. Now, the manager says you can get some chow to join about a mile down the road called the Silver Dollar Cafe. Now, remember, in bed by 10 o'clock. All right. Burrow, Channing, Dunkworth, Haddad, room number 8. Clinton, Hunter, Nowinski, Schwartz, room number 6.
Come on, Sly, you're with us. You guys, first one to the room gets to pick his bed.
And so, my young friends out there, are you doing what you should be doing? are what you should be doing. And if you're doing what you shouldn't be doing, then fall down on your knees and to pray. Mm-hmm. And to stay there. And then get off. This is to the Reverend Jesse.
James,
take this stick.
No. Here, let me use your pencil.
All right.
Move it, Clinton.
You think I should shave?
Shave? Pour some cream on your face and let the cat lick it off.
Well, gentlemen, let's go to town and get down.
Okay.
Let's go.
Hey, take those chicks over there giving us the eye.
Maybe they're just curious.
I like the one with the braces. Think we should go there and talk to him?
Well, what do you think Wild Bill would do?
Oh, Bill would have them all eaten out of his hand by now.
Yeah, but we don't have any peanuts.
Well, they're not elephants. The girls.
There you go. So you boys come all the way from Boston, huh? Just for my dynamite head?
Well, they sure are. Yummy for the tummy, and I got the tummy to prove it.
Wow.
Michelle, how about a little more coffee?
Will you keep your pants on?
They are on, can't you tell?
You know, it's nice to have some gentlemen around here for a change. How about some more fries, boys?
Well.
I see. On the house?
Sure, why not?
All right.
I think I'm in love.
Rochelle, can I get some change for the jukebox?
Sure.
Hi.
Hi. It's in the bag. I think she's crazy about you. It's love at first, second, and third sight.
Be quiet, man. Just cool, huh?
Hey. Yeah.
Do it, babe.
Yeah, for the honor of Boston, James.
Remember, the one with the braces for me.
I'll be done in a minute.
Go. Oh, hey, no rush. No rush at all. I'm James Hunter.
I'm Emmy Sharp. You must be from out of town.
Yeah, Boston.
Oh, that's really neat.
It's not too bad.
You must be in town for the swim meet, huh?
Yeah, tomorrow.
Oh, I know. My boyfriend's in it. I mean, he's not my steady or anything.
Well, how's the team? Any good?
Well, we've been to the state final the last 3 years in a row. And in 77, we were beat out in the last round.
Ah, kicking.
Bet your team's real good, too, being from Boston.
Well, we play hard. We swim hard, but we play hard, too.
You know, I was in Boston last summer. Oh, it's so neat there. I could scream. You know that ugly house on the right just when you come into town?
No, I don't think I noticed it.
Well, I've been living there ever since I was born. I mean, this town's the pits. There's nothing to do. This is it. Rochelle, silver dollar.
Well, the food's good.
Yeah, when Rochelle's husband is sober.
Come on, Emmy, let's dance.
Not now, Ernie. I don't feel like it.
Come on, Emmy. I really feel like dancing.
Ernie, I'm talking to James.
Pardon me for living.
He's the one who thinks he's my steady.
Good. Too bad you don't feel like dancing. I could show you a couple of hot moves.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
Hey, Ernie. Big deal. Boston hot shots.
Uh-oh. The natives are getting restless. We still got the moon and stars above.
Underneath the velvet sky, love is all that matters. Won't you stay with me?
I hate to poke a hole in your balloon, but it's 9:30 and we got to get split.
Oh, yeah, right, man. Hey, sorry, Emmy, but we have to be back at the motel by 10.
Oh, I understand. Training and all.
Yeah, big day tomorrow.
I'll be thinking of you.
Yeah, me too.
Come on.
Yeah. See ya.
Let's go on.
Yeah.
That chick's ears are steaming, brother.
And I gotta go back to the motel. Ah, the pits, man.
Yeah.
Well, fellas, I sure hope you enjoyed your food.
Oh, yeah.
Are you gonna come back and see me?
Yeah. Hey, the street lights are on. Past your bedtime, fellas.
Coachie has to tuck them in and kiss them nighty-night.
Hey, don't listen to them. They're just feeling their oats, you know.
Oh, you serve oats here. Well, let's go. What's the problem?
No problem. We just want to get to know you guys a little better.
Hey, that's a good idea, brother, but right now we're short on time.
Why don't you shut up?
Hey, just relax, man. You don't want any trouble.
Oh, yeah, that's right. You're a lover, not a fighter.
But hey, just lighten up, fella.
We don't like Boston ginks trying to mess around with our girls.
All I did was talk to her.
Yeah, and then you made her dance with you.
Well, maybe she just doesn't like the local talent.
You Boston punk!
Ah, you stupid hick!
Why don't you come outside and say that?
Why don't you try to make me?
Well, maybe I will.
Okay, let's see ya.
Well, you're after for it.
Yep.
Yeah.
What's the problem?
Oh, hi, Red.
Hi, Rosa.
We're just welcoming our visitors from Boston.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Everything okay?
Yeah. They were, just trying to tell us what we can do while we're here.
Just cluing you in on the scenic wonders of Oakville, right?
Oh, that's right, officer.
You keeping your nose clean, Ernie?
No sweat, Red.
Where you guys stand?
At the Sleep Right Motel.
Color TV in every room.
And hadn't you better be getting back? Like now?
Yeah, let's go, guys.
Bye, boy.
All right, thanks.
Hey, and as for you, how about a big piece of pecan pie and some steaming coffee?
Michelle, you are something special.
You're full of the blarney.
10-4, darling.
Well, bye, boys. Guess we'll see you at the meet. We'll be there.
Hitting on this local gal, and her old man wanted to hit on James.
That's just how it started with Wild Bill Kramsky.
Yeah, Bill was just talking to this chick. Next thing you know, bam, he had five of them coming back to the motel with us.
Well, did they spend the night?
Not the whole night. It was good while it lasted.
Yeah, because a little goes a long way.
Come on, come on. Who hasn't spent a night with a girl? What's the big thing?
Schwartz, if you're going to eat crackers, don't get them all over the bed, all right?
How about you, Hunter? You ever spent a night with a girl?
Maybe.
What about that girl from the Silver Dollar? Why don't you bring her back here tonight?
Yeah, bring her back here. And see if the one with the bracelet come back for me. Tell her the dude with the baby brown eyes digs her the most.
Now, hey, come on, you guys. We're here for a swim meet, remember? Besides, the coach said no girls in the rooms. Hey, Channing, if Hunter wanted to, he'd get that chick up here tonight. I say that with absolute assurance.
Bull. Man, she blew him a kiss. I saw it like this.
Well, why don't you bring her back here, Hunter? You are normal, aren't you?
As normal as any of you are.
Oh, no. When it comes to girls, nobody's as normal as me. No, you're abnormal, Schwartz.
Hey, when it comes to girls, abnormal is normal.
Hunter, I'll bet you two big ones you can't bring that chick back here to spend the night.
Huh? Hey, come on.
Cool it, man. I mean, you know the night before a meet is no time to be catting around.
I'll cover your $2. You can do it, Hunter.
Well, Hunter, what do you say?
Sure. Okay, I'll get her. Why not? And I got a $1.75 that says that little girl is going to spend tonight right here in this room. I'll cover that bet.
All right, well, I'll cover James then.
Okay.
All right, boy. Lights out.
Right, Coach.
Go get him, James, baby.
This is it. Now what?
Well, her friends at the cafe said she went home. But what am I going to do, throw a pebble at a window?
This ain't Romeo and Juliet, brother.
I hope not. They ended up dead. Hey, look. Think she'll come out?
These days, chicks are capable of anything.
From the cafe and said you wanted to say goodnight.
Oh, yeah. Well, I have a lot more to say than just goodnight.
You do?
Well, yeah. We hardly even got a chance to talk at the cafe. And Emmy, from the first time I saw you, I really liked you a lot. You just get those vibes right away, you know?
Oh, I know.
And, well, the night is young, and so are we. It's like two ships passing in the night. If not tonight, when?
I don't know.
That's just it. If we only had a place to be alone.
Well, we could go inside my place. You too.
No, I wouldn't want to disturb anyone. Let's see. Hey, I have an idea. Let's go back to the motel.
I don't know.
Well, it's our only chance to be alone. Together. If I had more time to spend in Oakville, I'd say we could just meet tomorrow. But we're leaving right after the meet. And Emmy, I want to spend as much time with you as possible.
Okay.
Emmy, listen, you gotta grasp every opportunity in life. You gotta go for it. Okay?
I'd love to go back to the motel with you.
I want you to know that you have just replaced John Travolta as the biggest hero in my life.
They worry about you?
Oh, they won't miss me. They never do. Anyhow, they're asleep.
Sounds like you've done this before.
Well, you never know, do you?
Oh, Emmy!
Did you hear that? Now that's a dirty laugh if I ever heard one.
What's so funny?
It was just, I remembered an old joke a guy once told me. Yeah. You know, you're really fun to be with.
I am?
Sure.
Oh, in Boston, you probably know a lot of experienced worldly women.
Yeah, but, well, they get boring after a while.
You know, once I had a kitty that looked exactly like that, except it was a different color. I love animals.
You're an animal, Emmy.
I want to faint.
Emmy,
you know, every time we go on trips, my dad steals ashtrays out of the motels. Well, we have one from Niagara Falls and one from Fort Lauderdale and one from Buffalo. Oh, it's so neat. It has a little picture of a buffalo in it. And so my grandfather was one of the founding fathers of Oakville. He had a big farm right outside of town of about 150 acres. Was it 150? It was either 150 or 125. I'm not sure exactly.
A little to the left. Oh, that's super. Oh, I could never reach there by myself. Oh, they're taking a shower. She's scrubbing his back. My heart. I can't stand it.
And so it was really humiliating. And after that, I decided not even to go out for cheerleading. Besides, other girls are super pretty.
Boy, I think you're super pretty.
You do?
Mm-hmm.
You're the first boy that's ever told me that. James, I just wanted you to know I don't mind if you go to sleep. I'll just sit here and look at you, okay?
Mm-hmm. That's fine.
Window, the coach and the guys.
I understand.
I'll see you at the meet later.
I'll be there. James, I won't forget this night for as long as I live.
Me neither. See ya. Hey, come in, coach! I guess I just slept too much. May I touch you? This is the finger that touched the fabulous James Hunter.
James, how come you look the same as you did before?
Right. Don't cool it, Clint.
Yeah. Hey, here's your money, babe. But you probably would have done it for nothing anyway, huh?
Could be.
Tired. Promised daughter a little too much for you?
Ooh. Who won the bet, Duke?
The 50-meter freestyle. In lane one, from Bunker Hill High, James Hunter. In lane two, from Oakville High, Ernie Wade. In lane three, from Bunker Hill, Don Black. Lane four, Oakville, Roger Morris. Lane five, Bunker Hill, William Clinton. Arnold Caston. Climbers, clear your watches. Swimmers up. Take your mark.
There's the gun, and six splashes are won. And coming out on top is Don Black with the lead we hope he can sustain. Battling it out for second and third are Caston and Morris, with Clinton right on their backs. Fourth is neck and neck between Ernie Wade of Oakville and James Hunter of Bunker Hill. Wade pulls ahead and challenges Clinton. They're coming into the turn now. Don Black still at the lead, and they're into the turn, and Don Black increases his lead, and he's swimming like the champ we all know he is. Ernie Wade has moved into third, behind Caston of Oakville second. Fourth and fifth are Clinton and Morris, with James Hunter in last place. Here they come now, they're bunching up, and Clinton begins to make his move. Here they go, and the winner is Don Black of Bunker Hill. First place, second place, Caston of Oakville. Third place, Clinton of Bunker Hill. Fourth place, Ernie Wade of Oakville. Fifth, Morris. And last place, Bunker Hill's James Hunter.
That's okay, Hunter. You can get him next time.
Sorry, Coach. I just couldn't get it going.
And the final beautiful score is Bunker Hill 84, Oakville 79.
Hey, man, you did your best.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm really wasted. I just didn't get enough sleep last night.
Yeah, I know, Johnny.
Oh, I'm so glad I got to see you. You were wonderful back there.
What, are you kidding? I'm lucky I didn't drown. Here, take this, will you, Duke?
Well, I just wanted to make sure you had my address. Please write.
Yeah, sure.
James, about last night, I just want to say, it was glorious. You were so neat to be with.
Yeah, well, you were something else yourself.
No one's ever made me so happy.
Listen, I don't know what else to say.
It's all right. We've already said it, haven't we?
Yeah, I guess we have. Let's see.
Account to, no one to check up on you, you know? I didn't win in swimming, but did all right in other areas.
Man, ever since he won that bet last week, he's been coming on like the Don Juan of Bunker Hill High.
Hey, Don Juan could take lessons from Mr. James Hunter.
So if you really need the help in biology, how about your place? Tomorrow.
Hi, James.
Penny. What are you doing here?
I ran away to be with you.
What about your parents?
I talked them into letting me stay with my sister. She goes to BU and she has an apartment just a few blocks from here. They know how I hate it in Oakville.
But school, I mean, what are you going to do about that?
I can go to Bunker Hill with you. I'm transferring my records.
You're going to Bunker Hill?
Won't that be neat? Now we can be together all the time.
We are heat. kids. Hey, hon, what's for dinner?
Bean.
Yeah, that'll be really neat. Together all the time.
Yeah, you're in deep water and you're going down for the third time.
Oh, what am I going to do? The girl thinks it's a great love affair and she's changed her whole life because of it.
Well, do you know what women have done for love? They move to foreign countries, let their children on doorsteps, even throwing themselves off bridges, all in the name of love.
Yeah, but listen, Sly, this has nothing to do with love.
Oh, that ain't quite the way I heard it. What about that night in the motel?
Well, the truth is nothing happened. It was all an act. We spent, well, that is, she spent the whole night talking.
I get it. You were doing a big man number. Let the fellas think you were the new Wild Bill Kransky, huh?
Yeah, I guess that's the low-down grim truth, all right. But man, did I blow it this time. I mean, the chick is serious. I'm her whole life. What am I gonna do?
Well, you better snip it in the bud before you're in heavy mud. Did you ever think about telling her the truth?
She knows nothing happened that night.
No, I mean the whole truth, about the whys and the wherefores of how come you invited her back to the motel in the first place.
What? Tell her that it was because of a dumb bet? Man, you don't know her, man. Who knows what she'd do?
Hey.
Oh, no.
Oh, hi, Sly.
Hi, Emmy. Well, I got a split. So I'll see you at the sub shop later.
That'll be neat, Sly.
Bye.
He's a great friend, isn't he?
Yeah. Listen, Emmy, I think we should have a talk.
Sure, James. I love our talk.
Emmy, you know that first night we spent in Oakville?
You think I could ever forget?
Well, I don't think you know exactly what it meant.
Of course I do. Because it meant the same thing to me.
No, it didn't. You see,
don't be embarrassed to say what you feel, James. After all, we love each other.
But we don't love each other, Emmy. See, Emmy, I asked you back to the room because of a bet.
A bet?
I bet the guys I could get you back to the room and keep you there all night. I won $1.75.
James.
Oh, yeah, if you do, sir, will you let me know? Thanks. Her sister said that when she came back from classes, Emmy wasn't there and all her stuff was gone.
Anyone else you can call?
Sly, I have tried every place I know. No one knows where she is.
Well, women have done dire things for love. Taken poison, gotten themselves bit by an asp, written poison.
All right, man. I feel bad enough.
Well, history has a way of repeating itself.
What's that supposed to mean?
Maybe this whole thing is going to end up right back where it started.
Hey, wait. Hey, Ernie. Hey, you seen that girl, Emmy?
Who?
Emmy, that new chick from Oakville.
Oh, yeah. Uh-uh. Not since she was in here with you, James.
Yeah, well, thanks. I was worried. I wanted to make sure you were okay.
Well, I'm okay. What were we talking about? What about those really neat shoes?
Emmy, could I talk to you a minute? Please?
We'll talk.
Alone.
Order me a cup of coffee. I'll be back in a minute.
Thank you.
Well, what is it?
Amy, I know you think I'm a crumb, and... Well, I don't blame you.
Is that it? Are you through?
I wanted you to know that I'm sorry.
Okay. Anything else?
And I feel terrible about what I did.
Is that it?
Well, just that I didn't mean to hurt you. I guess I was just trying to be some kind of real cool big shot or something.
Well, you did hurt me, James. You didn't think of me as a person. Just some silly little girl whose feelings didn't matter.
I'm sorry. But hey, don't cry. There's no reason to cry.
Don't tell me not to cry, Allah. I'll cry if I want to.
Oh, sure. If you want to, go ahead, cry.
Don't tell me what to do. I'll cry if I want to, or I won't cry if I don't want to.
Yeah, well, that's what I mean. Here.
You think you're so smart because you come from the big city.
No, I don't. But I just don't know what else to say. Maybe sometime you'll feel differently. And if you ever get to Boston again, I'd sure like to try to make it up to you.
Why? Did you bet your friends you could make me come back?
Emmy, I know this is going to be hard for you to believe, but I really think you're a super girl, and that's the truth. And I'd do anything if I could take back what I did. Well, I just wanted you to know that. Goodbye, Emmy. Tried, Sly, but she still feels pretty crummy. What am I gonna do?
You hurt her bad, James. A chick can't forgive and forget just because you wanted to.
Yeah, I know, but it sure bums me out.
Well, my man, we live and learn, don't we?
Yeah. But I sure wish the learning part would come a lot quicker.
Next, an offbeat investigator becomes a two-time victim when there's a murder in the family. Next.